This is the 2019 GMC Sierra Denali Ultimate. And quite simply, it doesn't get any more ultimate than this. This is the fully redesigned new 2019 GMC Sierra in the top Denali trim level with the top ultimate package for a sticker price of just shy of $70,000. This is the king of luxury pickup trucks. I've borrowed this Sierra Denali from Simpson Buick GMC here in Buena Park, California in Orange County, where the new 2019 Sierra has just started to roll in. And clearly, it's going to be a big hit. I say that because this truck is very impressive, and frankly, it always has been. Back when I was a kid, getting a pickup truck meant getting a bare bones, stripped down work truck with no features, and if you got the nicest one, maybe you would get leather. Then in the late 90s, early 2000s, GMC came out with a pickup called the Sierra C3, which later became the Sierra Denali, and the rest is history. Now everyone makes a luxury pickup truck, but this was the original, and it's still a sight to behold. This 2019 Sierra Denali is equipped with the Ultimate Package, which adds around $6,000 to the sticker price, but it really is ultimate because this truck has everything. So today I'm going to take you on a tour of the Sierra Denali Ultimate, and I'm going to show you all of the quirks and features of the new king of the luxury pickup truck. Then I'm going to get it out on the road and drive it, and then I'm going to give it a Doug score. And for more of my thoughts on this Sierra Denali Ultimate, click the link below to visit autotrader.com/oversteer, where I've also compiled a list of the highest mileage pickup trucks currently listed for sale on Autotrader. All right, I want to start the quirks and features by discussing the new Sierra's tailgate, which is quite impressive. Now, when you walk up to it, you'll see instead of a traditional latch you pull, there are two buttons, one on top, one on bottom. We're going to start on the bottom button. You press it, and then the tailgate comes down automatically, just like you'd expect from a luxury pickup truck. Not all that unusual, but you go back under the tailgate and you press the top button, and then this part comes down. Why is that? Because you can turn it into a step, and you can use this to step into the tailgate and easily access whatever you have in the bed. Now, the Ford F-150 also has a step, but this one is much wider. The F-150 step is only like a foot wide. This thing, you could have all your friends up here hanging out with you on your tailgate step. Now, you might think that's a big advantage, but the F-150 also has a tailgate railing. So when you're getting into your bed, you won't fall over. You can grab something to hold onto while you step up here. The Sierra doesn't appear to have a railing, does it? Ah, but it does. Over here on the side of the bed, there's this little item that kind of locks into place. When it's in place, you just lift it, grab onto it while you're stepping up, and then you're in and you can step into the bed a little bit more safely. When you don't want it, all you gotta do is just put it away and then it falls away. Now, when you're done stepping into your bed, folding all of this stuff up is pretty easy. Step one, step two, and then your tailgate goes back to being a normal tailgate. And check this out, the little step you were using a second ago can fold up and double as a little cargo stopper. So if you have like wooden boards back here, they can hit this instead of flying into the road while you accelerate. Another great idea. And the great ideas don't stop there with this tailgate. Check this out. Put the tailgate back up. You are once again confronted with the two buttons. This time, press the button on top, and only the top half can lower. And that way, if you have a wood board or pole or whatever, and you don't want to stick it flat, you can have it sort of sticking up so it doesn't shoot out when you accelerate. And once again, you can put the step up so it can act as sort of a cargo stopper so stuff won't shoot into traffic. It's a multifaceted tailgate design, and it is the most innovative truck tailgate in the entire industry ever. And the innovation continues back here. You see on the bumper, there's these little cutouts on the corners with these black ridges in them. This isn't unique to the Sierra, but it's kind of new to the pickup world. What that's supposed to be is a step. You're supposed to be able to put your feet in and then step up, giving you easier access to the bed. And from here, you press the little button, drop the top half of the tailgate, and getting to whatever you have back here has never been easier. Now, next up, we move on to the front of the Sierra, where the thing that immediately strikes you when you look at it is just how massive everything is. Look at the size of this huge chrome grille. It is just absolutely huge, but it isn't the only huge thing up here. You have the headlights, which to me look a little bit better than the Chevy Silverado's headlights. They're a little bit stranger with the new redesign. The Sierra is more traditional, but I especially especially like the fog lights. Look how massive these fog lights are. These fog lights are the size of headlights in most normal cars. But when you get a full-size truck, you get massive front everything. All I know is I wouldn't want to be hit by one of these if I was walking around. Next up, we move on to the interior of the Sierra Denali Ultimate. And I'm going to start, strangely enough, with the sun visor mirrors. You open up the sun visor mirror and you are greeted by three little LEDs on each side. But if you keep the mirror open, these lights sort of softly brighten to provide you with more illumination on your face as you look at yourself. It's a very classy appearance as these things brighten. It's sort of like what you'd expect from the bathroom in a luxury mansion. But a more important mirror-related detail is the actual interior mirror. Check this out. It's a mirror, just looks like a rear-view mirror like you have in your car, but if you pull the little tab that usually dims it, well, look, now it's a camera. Now, the benefit of the camera is obvious. It isn't impeded by headrests and pillars in back. Instead, it's all the way in the back of the car, and it gives you a much wider view of what's behind you. That camera is going in a lot of General Motors vehicles now, and it is a really brilliant idea. And I predict in 5 years, everybody is going to have rear-view mirror cameras instead of regular old mirrors. And I also predict that in 15 years, when those cameras eventually break, people are just going to tape regular old mirrors to their rear-view mirror cameras and go back to how it is today. Another interesting item inside the Sierra is this truck has an enormous amount of storage. The door pockets have a lot of storage in them. The center console is absolutely massive, full of huge storage. There's a little storage area on the top of the dashboard where you can put stuff, and there are two separate glove boxes. You have your lower glove box where you keep the owner's manual, and you have the upper glove box for even more gloves. Now, next up, I want to talk buttons and dials. This car has a lot of them. One of my favorite dials is over on the left, the steering wheel. It's unlabeled, but what it does is it changes the truck's drive mode, and you can select from four. There's an off-road mode and a tow haul mode, but there's also tour and sport. This is a truck with tour and sport mode, like I'm in some sort of Corvette. It's kind of funny to see that in a pickup truck, but this pickup truck has it. And speaking of buttons, I want to mention this truck has buttons for basically just about everything. There's an enormous number of buttons in this interior. For example, the truck has four separate buttons for four-wheel drive, four high, four low, two high, and auto. It's a long way from just pulling a lever like in old vehicles. There's also several buttons over on the door panel for seat memory, very tiny little buttons. There's a button for the full heated seat, and then there's a button just for the heated backrest. And of course, that's next to the button for the cooled seat. Even the parking brake has a button to the left of the steering wheel. In the old Sierra, there was a foot-mounted parking brake pedal, but now they've turned it into a button. There are so many buttons in this vehicle that even the turn signal stalk has a button on it, the button to turn on the windshield washers. Even the turn signal stalk is not safe from the onslaught of GMC Sierra buttons. The funny thing about all these buttons, though, is despite all the buttons, the button in the very middle in the center control stack is blank. There's one single blank switch in this entire truck, and it is the button that is closest to you in the very center of everything, reminding you that you have buttons for everything, but not that. Now, in addition to all the buttons, this truck does have the ability to plug in basically whatever device you could possibly have. There is a small USB plug, then there is a regular size USB plug, then you pop open a little cover and there is a cigarette outlet plug, and then there's a regular style household outlet plug. There's basically nothing you can't plug in to your Sierra. Now, another crazy item in this truck is the heads-up display, which is just wild. First off, it's huge, it's absolutely massive, but more than that, it can show an enormous range of things. The regular screen just shows the speed, what's playing on the radio, the usual stuff. But you can also change it to show this huge lane display that'll basically warn you if you're drifting from your lane. And that's not all. My favorite heads-up display item is the off-roader setting. You can have it show the vehicle angle, the vehicle tilt, whether it's in two-wheel drive or four-wheel drive. Basically, you can have a useful off-road display projected onto your windshield with an electronic screen while you're out there tackling the trails. It seems counter to the idea of off-roading to me, but I will say I would like that while I'm off-roading. Now, next up, we move into the gauge cluster. There's a big color screen in there that shows a couple of interesting things. One is that if you go into the info screen, you can see the oil life, the percentage remaining. That's pretty common, but this truck also will show you the air filter life and the brake pad life. And some cars will just say, oh, you need new brake pads. This thing shows you the actual percentage brake pads you have left so you can plan for when you have to replace them. That is very consumer friendly. When you're driving around, you want to know when you got to take it in for a brake service. Now, that screen that shows you the air filter life and the brake pad life, that's called the info screen, and it's configurable. You can add or remove displays from there. Some of the displays you can see are kind of geeky, stuff that nobody will really want, like transmission fluid temperature and engine hours. I also like the fact that one of the displays you can add to the info screen is blank page. What do you want to bet there was one like 94-year-old customer who wrote into GMC in a handwritten note and said, "I'm sick of all these displays in the middle, I just want to look at nothing." And so they gave him blank page. Next up, moving on to the infotainment screen, there are a couple of rather unusual items in here. One cool feature is just scrolling. This has one of the best scrolling ideas I've ever seen. You can use your finger to scroll through menus like normal, or over on the left, there are up and down buttons that scroll from page to page if you don't want to use your finger and just want to go through menus more quickly. That is a pretty good idea. It gives you two different scrolling options depending on whether you're just browsing with your finger or whether you're searching for something specific with the little page down displays. But one of my favorite things in this infotainment system, one of my favorite things I've ever seen in any infotainment system, is a setting called Friendly Prompts. This is for the voice control system, and it is hilarious. If you go into the Friendly Prompts menu, you will see it's not just turning it on or off. Instead, you get to choose how friendly you want the voice control prompts to be. You can choose friendly prompts, and then it will give you a friendlier prompt with more personality. Or you can choose off, and that will give you shorter and more direct prompts. In other words, if you want the prompts from the voice control system to be angry and gruff, as opposed to friendly and welcoming, or, this is my favorite, you can choose auto, and then it will respond in kind based on how you talk to it. So if you're very friendly, "Hi, GMC Sierra, how are you doing today?" it will respond in a friendly way. But if you just get in and say, "Take me home," it will also be short and gruff with you. That is one of the most hilarious choosable items I have ever seen in an infotainment system. Here's another interesting item. When you go into the infotainment system, you can choose a little item called trailering. When you go into trailering, you can see there's something called checklist. Click on it and it gives you three different trailers to choose from. Click on the trailer that you're hooking up to your truck and it actually takes you through a checklist of items that you need to complete before you can drive away with your trailer, and you can check them all off individually to make sure you have safely fastened your trailer and you're ready for a trailer trip. That is pretty cool. Perhaps even more interesting is the fact that you can add in your own trailer, and you can even give it a name. I'm going to name my trailer Bob, then it lets you choose what type of trailer you have. Now, the theory here is if you add in your own trailer, it will remember the settings you want, like your trailer braking and all that stuff, when your trailer is in place. And that way, when you go to hook up your own trailer, you just select Bob, it retains those settings, and it doesn't have to kind of figure out how big, how heavy, how long your trailer is to optimize the truck. That is a really good idea. Next, we move on to the rear seats in the Sierra Denali, where this truck's obsession with storage container places is taken to the max. Check this out. There's a little hoop in the seats. The middle section of the seats folds out and reveals a hidden storage compartment. That's actually a really good idea. More cars should have that. This one actually does. Aside from that, the rear of this truck is fairly standard. You have heated rear seats like you would expect in a luxury pickup truck. You also have, once again, plugs for a bunch of different stuff, micro USB, regular USB, cigarette out lighter, and you have a center armrest with a couple of cup holders. My favorite interesting quirk back here, however, is the rear center headrest. On the right and left, you have two normal headrests. In the middle, you have like the smallest 3-inch headrest I've ever seen, so as not to block driver visibility. I think that's kind of a funny little cute baby headrest just trying to make its way in the headrest world. And so those are the quirks and the mini features of the 2019 Sierra Denali Ultimate. Now it's time to get behind the wheel and see how it drives. Okay, driving the Sierra Denali. When you're just sitting in here, sitting in a stoplight, whatever, the first thing you notice is it feels like a luxury vehicle. I have to admit that the Ram Limited I drove, it had more sort of ornate trimmings and things like that. I think some people will prefer that and some won't. Some don't need like the saddle looking dashboard leather. Some just want nice stitched leather, and that's what this truck has. But if you want sort of more over the top kind of cool whatever, the Ram is more that. Getting out on the road, I love the driving position. The long hood, the hood of this truck is unusually kind of squared off at the end, even more than in other trucks. And trucks are known for being kind of squared off hoods. This one is particularly like that, but it gives you kind of a king of the road feel. Like you see to the end and then it drops down, and there's no curves like you're in some sort of sedan. You are the king of the truck world. The interior of this truck is nice. The materials, I think, could be a little bit better, believe it or not. The center control stack, there is some cheap plastic in here, which surprises me given the price point and given the competition. But the Denali name is certainly stronger than any of the rivals' luxury trucks. The Denali is sort of the Raptor of the luxury truck world. As the Raptor is to off-roader crazy trucks, this is to luxury trucks. With that said, even though the interior materials, in my opinion, don't quite measure up to some trucks, the ride quality is just fantastic. The truck dulls bumps like a luxury vehicle. The seat is very comfortable. You're sitting above everything, so you already have sort of the I'm on top of the world in a cloud kind of feeling, and then you actually are. The steering is really light, but that's kind of the point of a truck. Like, this isn't a sports car. I also like having that big bulky V8 under the hood. I'm embarrassed to admit it because I'm a fan of electric cars and I like, you know, conserving fuel, whatever. And I like the EcoBoost. But what I like more is hearing the rumble of a V8, I have to admit it. And honestly, just all the safety tech, I mean, rear cross traffic alert. So I put it in reverse and it lets me know if there's a car coming up behind me from either side where I might not be able to see. Massive mirrors with blind spot monitoring. It has the safety alert seat. So when you're backing up, and you're about to hit something, it vibrates the seat and doesn't just beep at you. I could go for days, trailer stuff. I mean, this truck just has an endless amount of equipment. All right, I'm gonna floor it. It's got some power, it has some pickup. It takes a while for it to get up to speed, which I guess should be no surprise. It doesn't just immediately start going like a sports car. Maybe if I put it in sport mode, that would change things. But it's got some good power, and it feels moderately, you know, powerful. Clearly, it's powerful enough to do anything. It's just never going to be like, whoa, my truck is sports car fast. I think it's a great vehicle, and it clearly is the kind of top quality luxury truck it has always been. I think my only gripe would be some of the interior materials, but in terms of equipment, pricing, engine, appearance, this is the Cadillac of trucks made by GMC. And so that's the 2019 GMC Sierra Denali Ultimate. The pickup market is very competitive right now. There's a brand new Ram, there's a new Ford Super Duty, there's a new Sierra and Chevy Silverado, and there's a new Nissan Titan, which will be purchased by approximately 11 people. But the Sierra Denali has always been the gold standard of the luxury pickup truck, and I'm happy to report that it still is. And now it's time to give it a Doug score.
Starting with the weekend categories and styling, the Sierra Denali looks nice. I like its traditional muscular pickup look. Still, it's no beautiful sports car, and it gets a 5 out of 10. Acceleration, somehow it manages 0 to 60 in 6 seconds, which gives it a 4 out of 10. Handling is floaty and vague, no surprise for a truck, and it gets a 2 out of 10. Fun factor is an easy one. This thing isn't about fun, it's about towing and hauling and luxury, and it gets a 1 out of 10. Cool factor, however, is decent compared to other trucks. The Denali name will always have a little extra brand value, and it gets a 4 out of 10 for a total weekend score of 16 out of 50. Next up are the daily categories, starting with features. The Sierra Denali is loaded with basically all the current truck goodies, and it gets a 7 out of 10. Comfort is excellent, and it's easily a 7 out of 10. Next up is quality, and I think the Sierra Denali's interior isn't quite on the level of the new Ram Limited. But I think overall, the Sierra has better reliability than anything Chrysler is likely to make, so it ties the Ram's quality score of 6 out of 10. Practicality is high, given the Sierra's big interior and its massive capabilities. It's dulled only by its huge size and its gas mileage, and it gets an 8 out of 10. Finally, value. The Sierra Denali is expensive, but it also delivers what it promises, a highly capable truck with luxury trimmings. But it is expensive, though, and it gets a 6 out of 10 for a total daily score of 34 out of 50. Added up, and the Doug score is 50 out of 100, and here's how it compares to some other new trucks. It beats out the Ram, but just barely. Personally, I would rather have the Ram Limited over the Sierra Denali if Chrysler could get its act together on quality. But until then, the Sierra Denali is the proven segment leader.